Welcome to Insight Hub, the video series dedicated to the world of data and brought to you by Miracles Data Practice.
Hello everyone, I'm Pravalika Tirunagari, working as Research Associate AI and ML at Miracle Software Systems. Our topic for today would be image recognition for inventory and merchandising of beverages. So let's quickly jump into the agenda. Our agenda for today, idea behind the application, solution benefits, then we'll be discussing about the architectural flow, the technology stack, followed by a live demo. Idea behind the application. Let me start it this way. For example, there's a customer coming in into the grocery store and searching for a product, but customer did not find the product and the store manager knows that there is a product available in the inventory, but it is not placed in the racks. So definitely grocery store may lose its customer. So the main purpose of this use case is to automate the regular monitoring of the products. So if there is a device stating if there is any empty space in the racks and the device notifies manager stating there is some empty space, you need to fill in the product with some products or a particular product or something. So this application is basically built using the machine learning technologies. So we have built two machine learning models which will actually detect the beverage bottles, so and also which will also detect if there is any void space available, that is if there is any empty space available in the racks, so that the store manager or the worker can fill in the racks with the product. So this application is basically a mobile application. The ML models are built and integrated into a mobile application. Solution benefits. The first and the foremost benefit to be complete automation. So here the store manager, in general, if we take, it is basically difficult for the store manager to like maintain all the products in the racks and also maintain other stuffs as well. So if we can automate the product availability system in the grocery store, then definitely that would be really helpful for the a store manager. So here in case if a product is reduced by its number, then definitely there would be some notification popping up or a notification sent to the manager's system or the mobile application stating there is some unavailability of the product and you need to like replenish immediately. That would be very easy. Like it is very easy to get updated. So this would actually avoid regular monitoring. So the store manager can focus on other works which are more important rather than going to each rack and finding out if the products are available and how many products are sold. All that stuff can actually be automated without regular monitoring. So these machine learning models, as I said earlier, can be integrated with any other hardware devices. Let us take an example like these machine learning models can be integrated with the camera. So here the camera as it works at 24/7 in the grocery stores. So the models will be running 24/7. And if there is any empty space available in the racks, then you can set a notification stating there is some empty space available, you need to fill in the racks. So these can be integrated with the cameras and the notifications and can be sent to the mobile application or the monitor that store manager is using. So that is actually making work easier. Let's discuss about the architectural flow. So the application that we have built is a mobile application. So here there are two modules which are included in the mobile application, that is the camera and the gallery module. The first camera module is where the user goes to a rack and clicks a picture of it and then gives that picture as a input for the models. And the other one is the gallery. The user can actually select images from the gallery and give those images as input for the models. What will happen when the user uploads a picture? So once the picture is uploaded, the first model, that is the rack identification model, which is basically a TensorFlow model. So that would be like first image or the image would hit the first model, that is the TensorFlow model. There in the image, the model will be searching for racks. That is how many ever racks the model finds will the image would actually divide it into those many ever racks. So for example, if there is an image given as an input for the rack identification model, and in the image if there are three racks, so the image would be divided into three different images, each consisting of one rack. The first image to be rack one, the second one rack two, the third image for the rack three. So these three images differently will be given as an input for the beverage bottle identification. These images separately will hit the Microsoft Custom Vision model. This model will actually detect the beverage bottles in the images. So here we have trained a model to detect the beverage bottles, and this model can also be trained products as well. So the beverage bottle identification model will give the count of each beverage bottle type. For example, in rack one, if there are two Coke 2-liter bottles, then and some space available for other bottles to be filled in, then the model will be giving like the rack one 2-liter bottles and also some void space. So that is basically how the application works. Technology stack. So the first and foremost thing is the Microsoft Custom Vision. So this is a service which is actually provided by the Microsoft Azure Cloud. So here it is basically an AI service, which is like an end-to-end platform to develop computer vision solutions for those problems. So here you just upload some images and give tags to that images and then train the model. The next time you give a new image of the same tag, then definitely the model will, rather than detecting, it will predict it belongs to one of the tags in the model. So that is basically Microsoft Custom Vision. The other model that we have used is the TensorFlow model. So this TensorFlow is basically built by Google. It is an open source library. So this TensorFlow can be used for numerical computation and also large scale machine learning. So actually the machine learning models using this TensorFlow library. I said Microsoft Custom Vision model, TensorFlow model. So how do you access the models? So using Python, we are actually accessing the models. Python is a general purpose interrupted, interactive and object oriented language. So it is a highly programming language. Here we have used it for integrating the models, for hitting the models with the images and getting the output out of the models. So here we have created the REST APIs using Python. So these REST APIs again are integrated with Ionic. So Ionic is again a open source SDK. So Ionic is used for hybrid mobile app development. And here we have completely built the mobile application using Ionic. And we have taken the REST API that we have created in Python and integrated that API into the Ionic mobile app. So here in the mobile app, when you click a picture and give it as an input, the API will be hit. In turn, the models will be hit and you will be getting the output. So let's check the live demo.
Yeah, so now let's check the demo for the mobile application. So if you can see the screen, there are two modules, camera and the gallery. The user can either click the images from the camera and give those images as an input to the machine learning models, or can just select the images from the gallery and then give those images as an input for the machine learning models. So these images would be given as an input for the API, and the API would be triggering the machine learning models and getting the output from those models. So let's check it with the gallery. Let's give one image. Let's see what is the prediction that the models are making for this image. So you can see there's only one rack. Yeah, so in rack one there are Coke 500 ml bottles, 9 are actually predicted. Yeah, so let's check with another image. These ML models are basically built for Sprite and Coke bottles. So let's see what will be the prediction. So if you can see in rack 1, it is 500 ml Sprite bottles, 10. And in rack 2, no predictions. But the racks are predicted. Let's see with another image. So here we have built the model with both Coke and Sprite. So let's see what will be the predictions for both rack 1 and rack 2. So if you can see, rack 1 Coke 500 ml 9 bottles, and in rack 2 Sprite 500 ml 9 bottles are predicted. So these ml models can also be like extended for other products also. We have built it for just the some of the beverage bottles. Thank you.
Thank you for watching a video on Insight Hub, the video series brought to you by Miracle's Data Practice. For more videos, please visit miraclesoft.com/insighthub.